हेलो एवरीवन, दिस वीडियो इज़ अबाउट क्रिचॉफ्स करंट लॉ. शॉर्टली इट इज़ कॉल्ड एस केसीएल एंड द ऑल्टरनेट नेम फॉर केसीएल और गिवन बिलो. इट इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एस द क्रिचॉफ्स फर्स्ट लॉ और क्रिचॉफ्स जंक्शन रूल और क्रिचॉफ्स नोड रूल और लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ चार्ज. सो दिस आर ऑल ऑल्टरनेट नेम फॉर क्रिचॉफ्स करंट लॉ. सो दिस आर ऑल may be asked in many competitive exams. What are the alternate name for KCL? Or KCL is also known as dash, like that. And KCL depends upon which one. It may be a law of conservation of charge or law of conservation of energy. So the correct answer will be law of conservation of charge. So let us see the statement of Kirchhoff's current law. So the algebraic sum of all the current entering and leaving the junction must be equal to zero. So at a node or a junction point in a circuit, the sum of current entering into the node will be I1 plus I2 plus I3, and the current leaving from the node is I4, I5, I6. The sum of current entering into the node plus the sum of current leaving the node is equal to zero. So otherwise, the Kirchhoff's law also states that algebraic sum of current entering the node is equal to algebraic sum of current leaving from the node. So consider this node A. The current entering into the node is I1, I2 and I3. These are all the arrow marks towards the node A, so that the current is entering into the node, and the current leaving from the node is I4, I5 and I6. These are all arrow marks away from the junction, so that it is the current leaving from the node. So that according to the KCL, sum of current entering into the node is equal to sum of current leaving from the node A. So this circuit, I1, I2, I3 are the current entering into the node, so that I1 plus I2 plus I3 is the summation of current entering into the node, and I4, I5, I6 are the current leaving from the node. So equal to, that is, the sum of current entering into the node equal to sum of current leaving from the node I4 plus I5 plus I6. And this is one of the statement. And from this equation, we can write it as I1 plus I2 plus I3, and bring the equation from right hand side to left hand side. It is minus I4 minus I5 minus I6 equal to 0. Just we are replacing this equation into this equation. And now the sum of current entering into the node is I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus of current leaving from the node equal to 0. This is the another one statement. Summation of current entering into the node and the summation of current leaving from the node equal to 0, or summation of current entering into the node is equal to summation of current leaving from the node. So this is the two statement for KCL, that is the Kirchhoff's current law. So now let us see why KCL is also known as the law of conservation of charge. We know that the current I is nothing but rate of change of charge, that is the charge changing with respect to time, that is called current. Flow of charge is called as the current. Okay, and now in the previous statement, we have written this equation I1 plus I2 plus I3 equal to I4 plus I5 plus I6. We know that I is equal to Q by T. So in this equation, instead of current, just replace charge by time. So I1 is Q1 by T, I2 Q2 by T, and I3 is Q3 by T, and equal to I4 is Q4 by T, and I5 Q5 by T, and replace I6 as Q6 by T. So in this equation, 1 by T will be common in both sides, that is the left side and right side. We are having the common terms, 1 by T, take outside and cancel out each other. The remaining terms are Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 and equal to Q4 plus Q5 plus Q6. So we can write the equation is, the charges entering into the node is equal to charges leaving from the node. And again, we can state like this, that is, the law of conservation of charge is nothing but net charge in the wire is constant, that is conserved. In a closed loop, the net charge is constant. So in the previous equation, this is the charge entering into the node plus the current leaving from the node is this one, and the summation of charge entering into the node plus summation of charge leaving from the node is equal to zero. That is, the energy can either cannot be created or not be destroyed. Like that, the charge is not modified in a particular closed loop. It is constant. This is the law of conservation of charge. KCL will follow this law of conservation of charge. And see one numerical example for a better understanding of KCL. Consider the circuit. V is the voltage source. There are three resistors R1, R2 and R3. Assume current I1 is 5 amps, I2 is 2 amps and I3 is 3 amps. At a node A, I1 is entering into the node and the current I2 and I3 both are leaving from the node. So at a node A, according to the KCL, current entering into the node is equal to current leaving from the node. So current entering the node is 5, current leaving from the node is I2 is 2 amps and the I3 is 3 amps, 3 plus 2, 5 amps. So KCL states that current and summation of current entering into the node is equal to summation of current leaving from the node. So bring 5 in to the left side, 5 minus 5 is equal to 0, so that sum of current entering into the node and the sum of current leaving from the node is equal to 0. So this is the proof for Kirchhoff's current law. So the current entering the node plus the current leaving from the node is equal to 0. And the better, that is the main application of this Kirchhoff's law is, to, is used to identify the current in the branches of your network. It is having the nodes. If not subscribed our channel AAA Encyclopedia, subscribe and click bell icon and also click all for getting all notifications.